follow you, God. I don't want to miss the amazing things you have planned for me. And even when it's hard to see, you are never leaving me. I am so excited now, dreaming what it's all about. Even when it's hard to see, you are never leaving me. I am so excited now, dreaming what it's all about.
Which is the best plan for my very own mini golf course. I'm building it right here in the clubhouse. I was thinking these two box lids could be the path for the ball to follow. Oh, and I can also draw a blue pond right here. This big pom-pom from my art supplies can be the ball. This cup can be the hole for the ball to go into. This wrapping paper roll can be the club. Pretty cool plan, right?
Hoo! Hoo!
It's Ollie!
Hello, Hayden. Hoo! Hoo! What is this creation set up by you?
Hi, Ollie. I made my very own mini golf course. Isn't this the best plan ever?
It is a wonderful plan for golf. That's true. But there's someone who makes the best plans for you. Listen to this story.
Just follow me through.
Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through. Follow me through.
Soon, Stormy? I'm sure they'll be here soon. Oh, there you are! Look, Stormy! There's our friends! I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane. We've been waiting for you because we want to finish the story about Joseph and God's plans for him. Are you ready for the story? I know Stormy is. So today's true story from the Bible begins with Joseph. This is Joseph. Joseph's dad gave him a very special coat, which made some of his brothers very mad. They sent him far away to work. Then Joseph was sent to jail for something he didn't do. Do you think Joseph still trusted God, even though it was hard? Yes, he did. And God's plans for Joseph weren't finished yet. The king of Egypt named Pharaoh had a crazy dream, and he didn't know what it meant. He heard that Joseph was very good at understanding dreams, so he had Joseph brought to the palace to talk to him. Joseph was happy to talk to the king about his dream. Joseph listened to Pharaoh, and God helped Joseph understand the dreams. Joseph told Pharaoh to save food for 7 years, because after that, there would be 7 years where no food would grow. Pharaoh was so happy that Joseph helped him, so he put Joseph in charge. Joseph got to work saving food in Egypt for 7 years. It was all part of God's plans. Let's count to seven together. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now look, wow, Joseph saved up so much food, which is good because just like God said, the food stopped growing and everyone needed food to eat, including Joseph's family. They didn't have any food, but who saved up all the food in Egypt? Their brother Joseph. Joseph forgave his brothers for what they did to him, and he made sure everyone in his family had food. Yay, Joseph! Let's cheer for Joseph because he trusted God's plans for him, even when it was hard. Yay, Joseph! And now, let's cheer for God, because God loves us and God's plans are always best. Yay, God! Hey there, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who has plans for you?
God has plans for you. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has plans for you?
God has plans for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story, and it's all true. God's plans are always best. God's plans for me and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, God's plans for Joseph were bigger than Joseph could ever imagine. That's because God's plans are always best. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I'm so glad that God has plans for me. See you next time. Bye!
For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11.